Praise be to Jesus Christ. Way to Bethlehem, day 11. Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste, into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. The haste or urgency of movement shown by Mother Mary is our reflection point of the day. What a brave lady she was. And we can't even imagine the risk that Mother Mary taken to reach the home of Elizabeth. No traveling facility as we have today. A place which was unknown to her. A journey by only walking. Stepping behind the hills and mountains she traveled. The inspiration and motivation behind this adventurous trekking was that Mother Mary could see the need and necessity of her presence in the home of conceived Elizabeth. The hastiness for outpouring the heart and stretching the hands towards the needy. The hastiness to do and say good for others. The hastiness to burn and give light for others. The hastiness to find priorities of others' need than mine. The haste of Mother Mary shows the complete undertaking and action of Holy Spirit on her entire life. Yes, my dear sisters, we could also find out some people in our day-to-day life with the same thrust of doing good for others. They live their life as like sodium alkali metal put in water, which shows a quick and vigorous reaction and movement. Even in this pandemic situation, we found many healthcare workers who were running to save the lives. Late Reverend Father Stan Swami, who silently and bravely showed his hastiness for the justice to poor tribal people. Another living example, Reverend Father Davis Chiramel, the kidney father. He started with many kinds of good charity works with the real spirit and urgency to reach out to poor who are in need. There are thousands of missionaries, including the CSC daughters, who shows their haste and urgency for the well-being of poor and needy. The founder of CSC, Venerable Augustine John Ooken, was the best and foremost example of haste like Mother Mary, who was well known as the Achan Thamburan only because that he showed his interest and thrust towards the poor and downtrodden. As we prepare to receive Jesus in our hearts, let's celebrate Christmas by reaching out to poor and needy. Let's all show our haste to do good, to open our eyes to our neighbors. Maybe they are in need of our simple smile, our presence, our accompaniment, our friendship, etc. Let's be a good friend and good Samaritan to all, even to our unreconciled past enemies. Thank you. May the infant Jesus bless you all.